Good evening, students. Welcome back to the class. In the last class, you had studied about migration. Today, we are going to learn about settlements. Let's study about settlements. The clusters of permanent or temporary human habitats of different sizes are termed as settlements. Let's see the factors influencing the settlements. Favorable climate, availability of water, fertile soil, transport and communication facilities, job opportunities, etc. are the factors influencing the settlements. Let's study about types of settlements. Human settlements are classified into two types based on population and their major economic activity. They are rural settlements and urban settlements. Let's learn about rural settlements. Rural settlements are comparatively low population where the people largely depend on agriculture for their livelihood. Houses are constructed using locally available raw materials. Okay, next, let's study about the types of rural settlements. On the basis of distribution pattern, rural settlements are divided into two. They are nucleated settlements and second one, dispersed settlements. Let's learn about nucleated settlements. Settlements in which houses are grouped close together are called nucleated settlements. The characteristics of nucleated settlements are: this kind of settlements is formed in the fertile river valley plains. People of these settlements have strong social relationships. Employment of the people are based on that region. Okay, next, let's study about dispersed settlements. The settlements where houses are located further apart from each other is called dispersed settlements. Let's see the characteristics of dispersed settlements. This kind of settlements are mainly found in undulating topography or uneven landforms. Second one, due to unfavorable conditions, people living in isolation. In such settlements, the people are brought together by places of worship, markets, etc. There are some places where the settlements are neither fully nucleated or dispersed. Such settlements are called semi-clustered settlements. Let's see the patterns of rural settlements. There are three types of patterns of rural settlements. First one, linear pattern. Second one, circular pattern. And third one, star pattern. Let's learn about linear pattern. Settlement pattern that develops parallel to features such as roads, rivers, railway lines, coastlines, etc. Next one, circular pattern. Settlement patterns that develops around features such as water bodies, pastures, places of worship, etc. Last one, star pattern. Settlement pattern that develops at places where different roads converge. Okay, students, let's conclude the class. Today we learned about settlements, types of settlements, factors influencing the formation of settlements, and different patterns of settlements. Hope all of you understood these topics. Meet in the next class with the continuation of the chapter. Thank you.